I'm Alan Hall, President and CEO of WeatherGuard Lightning Tech, here to offer you some helpful tips when selecting a segmented lightning diverter for your next radome project. So there are a number of things to know about a segmented lightning diverter. I think the first is just to get a sense of what it is and what it can do. As you can see, this is a segmented lightning diverter from WeatherGuard Lightning Tech, which we call StrikeTape, but it is extremely flexible. And it'll contour to almost any radome surface. So it is relatively simple to lay this down on the most complex of shapes. So don't worry about having a very uniquely shaped radome or very tight corners. Lightning diverters, segment lightning diverters will fit almost every application. So let's talk about the specifics of the segmented lightning diverter and how do you specify what you need or what you want for your particular radome project. And the first thing is color. What color to paint the surface? So the buttons on our diverters are always gold, and that's real gold plating, but the color on the plastic material can be chosen. And most aircraft are painted white, and most radomes are painted white, but the color can be any color to match your application. We paint diverters black, we paint them gray. Whatever color you need for your specific application, just let us know and we can paint our diverters to match. The next thing to know is that diverters come or can come with a VHB double-sided tape from 3M, which makes the diverter basically peel and stick. So, and I'll show you an example here. This is a peel and stick application here. You can see the tape on the back side of the diverter here. And it just has a release liner. You peel the release liner off and you stick the diverter onto your radome. It makes the installation very quick and simple and clean. And most of our customers, 90% of our customers, choose a diverter with the 3M tape on the backside. Makes the installation easy. A couple other things to know about a segment and lightning diverter, which you can choose from, are the terminations. And right here I show three different types of terminations. They're most common, and again, in the 90 percentile case, is the cut edge or just clipped off diverter strip, because it's the simplest to install. And the way that the diverter gets grounded is a common question, is that that end of the diverter is just placed next to a grounded screw or a piece of grounded structure on the airframe. So the lightning just jumps off the diverter to the screw and away the lightning goes. Relatively simple to install, cleanest installation. But some of our customers like to use dimpled washers. So radomes are usually attached with a series of screws, 100 degree countersink screws. And we offer terminations in two standard sizes, which is a number 10 dimpled washer or a quarter inch faster dimpled washer. And again, they're 100 degree countersinks, so they fit right into the screw hole and the screw will mount right through them and made up appropriately. The dimpled washers don't provide any necessary electrical function, but sometimes it is easier on longer diverters to have an anchor point. So you put the screw in through the dimpled washer and you can lay the diverter down on the radome. It sometimes makes it a little bit easier, and some of our customers prefer that, but for the most part, our customers choose the edge termination. So the last thing to know, and it's really dependent on the application, the radome application, the frequencies of the antennas that are underneath that radome, which button to choose. So it can be a little complicated at first, but let me explain it here so you can see how this works. So with lower frequency antennas, the wavelengths are much longer, like with a weather radar and VHF radio comm antennas or nav antennas. Our oval button diverter is probably the right choice there. It is RF transparent from about 9.4 gigahertz and frequencies below that. It has great lightning performance and are used all over the place on many applications all over the world. So the oval tends to be our highest selling product. The next one is the large round. The large round button diverter has 125-inch diameter buttons on them. There's a series of them here. And that tends to get used on KU SATCOM radomes, tail radomes, dorsal radomes, things of that sort. Very popular choice for those KU band SATCOMs. And then for KA band SATCOMs, of which there's plenty of today, the small round button is the choice because it doesn't interfere with the KA band antenna system. So KA band, small round button diverter, you see our product used on all kinds of airplanes all over the world. Customers are extremely happy. But these are the three button types, from oval to large round to small round. If you have questions about the frequency of your project and which is the right diverter solution for you, feel free to reach out. We can answer your questions. There are a lot of resources that we do provide about segmented lightning diverters on our YouTube channel. And also check out our website, because there's a lot of useful information there at weatherguardarrow.com.